What allergic asthma and what it's been considered over these years is asthma induced by allergies. The classic example of allergy-induced asthma or allergic asthma is I'm allergic to a dog or a cat. I walk into a room with a cat or dog, I play with the cat or dog, and then that induces asthma. People with allergy-induced asthma also have asthma to other things too. They may also have asthma when they get a cold or viral-induced asthma. They may also have asthma if they have bad reflux. They may also have asthma if they're exposed to things like cigarette smoke or toxic chemicals. Allergic asthma has been used for many years to describe people with allergy-induced asthma, but these patients, as we're finding out, are much more complex than that. Allergic asthma, in my mind, is diagnosed a lot clinically. Did they have one or more of these other atopic conditions? And then also you do skin testing to verify that they have allergies. And so what that involves is you bring the patient into clinic, you take the allergens or little proteins that we think people may be allergic to, for example, cat protein, dog protein, pollens. We dip it into the protein and then we scratch the skin. And then when you scratch the skin, if they're allergic, it'll swell up, become red and itchy. And so really, the diagnosis of allergic asthma is both very much dependent on the clinical history of what they tell the doctor, but then also verified with some skin testing. There's also a couple more testing that we do. We do things called exhaled nitric oxide, where people breathe out and it measures inflammation. We see that is often elevated with allergic asthma, but it really is still very much dependent on the physician's history and a consideration of the person as an individual. The treatment of allergic asthma should consist of avoidance. If there's no clear trigger that we can do anything about, like say, for example, pollens, typically we have a rescue inhaler when they have symptoms, but then also we have a maintenance medication. And the maintenance medication is there to reduce inflammation.